Hey, glad you're back. Welcome to, what is this?
Lesson 6.
Yeah, lesson 6 of John and Mike's Big Follow Lesson Bobby Slama. So, today's lesson, we're going to teach you how to, Rick Caven. Thank you, producer Kelsey.
It's that time again.
Juice time.
The cultural portion of our lesson, brought to you by our producer.
I love culture.
I want to do the culture first next time.
Whatever floats your boat, mate.
Mate.
We're geographically very close to Australia, so it kind of picks up.
Australia, our smallest continent.
Is Antarctica smaller?
I don't know.
We'll take that as fact. So, today is lesson 6. Let's learn how to address people when you forget their names.
It happens.
Including your own, which you might address as I.
In English.
Of course we're talking about English right now. But this goes into Bishlama as me.
Not capitalized. Exclusive English.
Whatever, mate. So me. This also includes the other version of I that we use in English called me with an M. E?
In English, we have subjects for the nominative case, and we have direct objects and indirect objects.
This is why we need to.
So, I'll be explaining the technical presence of these lessons. So,
that's what I was talking
as
about.
As with many European languages, which is what I'm assuming most of our viewers, the background that they're coming from,
English,
English,
French,
yeah. German,
yeah.
Yes, dudes. Oh, that one's for you, Jeremy. So, in English, we have I and me. Okay, me being the direct object or indirect object form of the pronoun that we know as I. In Bislama, lucky for you learners, they basically got rid of all that BS and they narrowed it down to me no mo.
Me.
No mo being only.
So, of course, your subject is just going to be when you're talking about yourself, me. Mm. Or if you put yourself at the end of the sentence, it's still me.
For all you English speakers, you might even say they took a play out of our playbook when it comes to you, because many other European languages kept a direct object and an indirect object form of you. But in English, we're like, no way, man!
You. It's
yeah.
Just the Bishlama spelling of our very familiar English, you.
That's right.
Plural. Oh, should I jump across the
not
board?
Yet. No,
not
no,
yet.
No. We are on the singular side, which is why there's only an S next to the you, saying that it is the singular form, meaning there's only one.
C, nice one. Top 5.
Ooh. That's actually part of the native language that we will
ooh.
Not be covering.
Ooh, sense. we went back.
Bonus!
Okay, he, she, it. Oh, John, you didn't give me enough space to
write. Wait. I actually read our letter ahead of time for our Dear John segment, and I
that's why this is the mistake is here. Okay. I thought it was a mistake. You didn't give me enough room to write what he, she, and it was.
No.
This is not
today's letter.
From who?
Let's take a look.
I can't find it. Where is it on your problem?
It's usually at the bottom right of the letter.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Oh, I see. Goodness. Today's letter from Nathan.
Thank you, Nathan.
Shout out to you, buddy.
I'm going to move the chops.
I'll have you know that Nathan actually won our competition. Our videos have become so popular that we sifted literally ones of letters at a time.
Oh my god, it's
not tens, not hundreds, not thousands, but literally ones of letters at a time. And Nathan writes, Dear John, I noticed that in Bislama, they don't seem to separate between masculine, feminine, or neuter gender. In fact, the third person singular seems to only have one translation. And it just doesn't matter at all. Do you find that to be confusing? Well, that's a great question, Nathan. Thank you for your question.
Thank you.
Generally speaking, no. A cultural note. The Vimalavati consider Bislama to be a language of Storia, and the culture of Vimalavati to be a culture of Storia. As such, there's enough Storia being stories, or speaking,
Yes.
As such, context clues play a big part in what's happening in the grammar and the language that you're currently learning. So, without further ado, I invite Mike to please write the definition or the translation.
I'm gonna just make that lowercase. I guess. Consistency.
So, one thing that we missed in our very first lesson, which if you go back, you can fact check this, and we do want you to go back and review those lessons.
Please do.
The letter H. Sometimes it makes a noise, depending on the part of the country that you are in, or just your general background. In general, repetition is a part of Islam. The H sound, oh, it's a juice time, our producer is signaling that it's time for juice.
Woo! Cheers!
Cheers, buddy! Or prost for our German viewers.
Or drink for our English.
Mm. Juice.
Juice.
The H sound sometimes makes a noise, and sometimes does not. As in the American English word, herb, or basically every French word that puts the letter H in it. So, it is entirely up to you if you would like to what? To say the letter H.
Hoffman.
Hem. Like Hank Hill.
Man, I love that.
Or not say it at all. And in fact, in your spelling, not even.
H2O.
Or in your spelling, not even put the H. Entirely up to you. That's one of the wonders of this language. It's basically entirely human.
Truly it is, but I will counter your statement.
Please
and
do.
Say it really depends on your location, because each island has its own subculture of its own, where maybe they're more familiar with the hem, or they're more familiar with the M.
Generally speaking, it depends on if it was a part of a more English influence area or a French influence area.
Mm-hmm.
Which really doesn't even depend on the island, but on specific areas of the island itself.
Ah, yes, it's true. But we could generalize about islands, but it really depends on where you stop. Excuse me, we have not covered that lesson.
Live.
Where you exist and live. So, you can use either, anyone would understand you, but what is the usual form depends on where you are.
Or stop.
Or stop. We will talk about that.
It's an illusion, not an illusion, but an allusion to a future lesson.
CCC. Thank you, John. Alright, may we continue?
I think we will.
We
moving on to we!
Column number two.
Okay, so you'll notice that Mike has drawn a line here. The left side of the line.
I don't know where you're going!
Being the singular side. For all of those singles out there.
Hey.
But the right side of the line being for all of us plurals out there. Brady, this one's for you.
I broke the
chicken.
Oh, no. Hand me my orange cup for my orange hair and your red cup for your red hair.
You just broke the chalk. It's juice time so that Mike can have the vitamins that he needs to break more chalk.
Life's rough. Keep the vitamins in.
It's true.
Anyways, is it my time to continue?
Yeah. Only if you could talk about inclusion and exclusion.
That's what we're going to discuss next.
Whoa!
I'm glad you said that. Nice. Alright, so we, there is a very convenient branch off of we to help me remember to do the right thing here.
That is not a less than sign. It should not be confused with our friend, Patrick.
Alright. The first pronoun I will introduce is you, me.
Which you might notice looks like two other pronouns that already exist.
Yeah, it's very easy to see you and me put together into one word makes the verb
pronoun.
The pronoun we. So
inclusive. Inclusive.
You and me make what? You, me.
It's great to be included.
Yes.
But we do understand that we are excluding
the other
fine folks out there and our producer Kelsey. Mm.
Sorry, Kelsey. Sorry
about that.
Can't.
Oh.
Inclusive.
Exclusive.
Do you want me to put this one on? Okay, just make sure. Okay. Wait, those A's don't look nice. Let me fix it.
I think they look nice. But you should do the backwards eyes like that.
They don't do that much. We're having a disagreement about.
No, actually, I can't around. I can't around.
Okay. Alright, the other option being to include to.
Exclusive.
No, I just mean me, but hey. In the exclusive form of we.
So, we have the you me, meaning you me.
And
my.
Stop the lesson and say, you, me, yes, there's us two here speaking, but we could be referencing everyone in the whole environment.
World.
No, just in this context.
That's too exclusive to me.
No, the you, me could be him.
You, me, three.
You, me, three, including him.
Nice.
Oh my goodness, it could be you, me, more than three. We don't know who's out there right now. It's you, me. Us. I see. I see at least two eyes.
That's true. That's true.
At least two eyes.
That's true. Alright.
I hope there's no one with one eye.
Because that's exclusive. We're trying to include all of them.
We're trying to be inclusive.
That's right.
So. With you, me, and Mifala.
So, Mifala being the exclusive form, meaning Mike and me only, not you guys. So,
thank you, producer.
Mifala, a teacher of Bizlama, Lord, Chloralino,
Mifala,
as students.
Whoa, so now this is where we have to draw the line. And the line is.
I'm gonna literally draw the line.
No, they won't see the line on the floor. Let me just do this. It's a wall. It's
right.
A plane.
I'm gonna literally drip the juice.
It's a plane. This is the plane. You follow, me follow, me follow.
Me too follow. But we haven't gotten numbers yet, so don't worry about that.
Me follow.
We'll get to a bonus.
You follow, me follow. Do we go to they now, or do we have to explain the me too follow?
Alright, so just as a review, you me being you me as in every single we person involved in these lessons.
Wait,
right now.
One second, I have to disagree.
I don't know if I disagree with that.
From my super intense studies and in-depth research, there's also the option to put parentheses.
No, we're not there yet.
Oh
we don't know numbers yet.
This is not numbers. This is you meet everyone.
Okay, we're not there yet. But okay.
Are we really not there? Are we not there? This is the time. This is the time.
Sorry, you think that we did pronouns. We're going to be a little bit too early because we didn't do numbers yet. Because in order to get to Yumi everyone, we need to do Yumi 2, Yumi 3.
Except for our English speakers.
English speakers!
This is very clear to you.
Francophones, I want you to come back to this lesson after you review the number lesson for this to be clear.
I'm going to rephrase what I said. You follow.
Nice.
Yes.
Or you too follow because there's probably only two of you.
We're not popular.
We get a lot of letters, literally once of them.
Once. This goes both of my binary lessons to students.
Both of them. Zeroes and ones, nice.
And
so, anyway.
Yeah, so, you, me, is like the group in context.
If you're in our group, which you are because you're one of our viewers,
it's
you are a you, me.
It's the group in context, yes. But as soon as you add the adjective everyone to the end, you are literally saying,
Every single person who wants to be included is in.
Yes, that is correct.
This might sound like an infomercial, but it's not. You're in. You're in.
Exactly. So, you, me, is whoever's in the current conversational context, and then you, me, everyone is like every person that you could imagine that's relevant to whatever the
right.
conversation.
However,
is.
Mifala is exclusive, meaning. Some people are going to be
me
excluded,
but not you.
Like
not you.
You can find us in the club, but But we
not finding you in the club. Bouncers keep you out.
Although yesterday, in a culturally relevant note, I did see somebody in town wearing a shirt that says all bouncers are pussies.
So we're...
Well, no, the pussy bouncers are keeping them out. So they need to go train a little bit more and they can beat those bouncers. And then you'll be a part of Uni.
Yeah, you can get there one day.
You can get there. By watching these lessons, you're going
to
be a part of
them. This is really an infomercial. We're telling them they can get to it.
But it's free. We're not selling it. We're selling knowledge.
We're selling ad space.
Thanks for watching that ad when the video started. We made a whole penny off of you.
Thank you, guys. Alright, so Yumi, everyone is the optional. You mean seriously everybody. And then as soon as you get to Mifala against Yufala, here being the plane of separation.
Exclusion.
The plane of exclusion. It is now you, me, Mifala.
It was you and me against the world.
Mifala against Yufala out there.
Which brings us to they, the people that aren't Yufala and aren't Mifala or Yumi. Our producer Kelsey falls into this category with our other producer, Kelsey.
Let's pretend she's plural. That's the only way to put this.
Kelsey's. Bilal is going to be very happy about that.
Yeah. Pretend Bilal and Kelsey are out in the world over there. On the other side of the exclusion plane.
And like the other side of the like super exclusion plane. Because they aren't even Yufala. They're like Bilal and Kelsey.
We're like all get them?
They are like all get them.
That's perfect segue. So they
save. Nice save. Oh, I mean, nice addition to our lesson.
The juice just came out of the view. What is it called?
Plane of sight.
Plane of sight.
The exclusion.
Well, I'm not a film major, so I don't know what I'm talking about.
I'm just a German major.
Hey, let's flatten this.
He'll flatten this.
You don't have to. Don't worry. Save it. So, they, and I'm going to update what he said with my third grade.
Well, we should have also done us then, out here.
Forget it.
No, we can't forget that. It's like the most important part of this whole lesson.
Okay, so Mifala is basically us.
Remember how we talked about the I-me's?
Yeah.
We talked about the we-us's and the they-them's.
We is you, me, us is Mifala. Us. Exclusive. Mifala. Alright, so they is Algeta. Them is also Algeta. It just means a plural. How do I even say this? I'm actually kind of confused.
It's third person plural.
That's it. That's what
third
it
person.
Is. Third person.
I being the first person, you the viewer being the second person, and they, those people that are watching, he, she, and it.
The people, there's a whole group of people standing outside of screen to this side, they are they.
Much like our producer, Kelsey.
Yeah, Kelsey's in the they. She is part
She's in the they.
Hemi, blog.
Inside, one word, but you feel like sound introduction. Inside, low, all,
get to that. Which can also be shortened to, we're not ready for that.
We're not ready for the thing where you cut letters off of a word.
All versus all get to, we're not ready for that. We'll get into that.
We are ready for mosquito words.
We're ready for what?
Mosquito words.
It is becoming wet season, which means mosquito eggs are hatching. Which means we are very unlucky people right now.
So you're lucky that you're not included in the Yumi, and that you guys are the Yufala.
You're lucky you're not included in the malaria, and
yeah.
In the...
And
we don't know where they're from, but mostly...
You might be included in the malaria,
might
which
be.
Is thanks for tuning in anyway.
Yeah.
But...
Do I continue to...
So... These are the pronouns as we've seen fit to teach them as they are now. We will, however, get into some future lessons where we include some numbers in the pronouns and even some contractions. So with that, I think it's time for us to add some French words.
For the dictionary.
All right, you do that, and we're gonna multitask. I will write all the French translations.
Okay, you right behind me. You don't pay attention to him. Kelsey, you tell me when.
Stop.
Okay, column one, through 4.
Me tink say by me chusem column number 3.
That is 3 in English, so 1, 2, 3. And it looks like you have about 8 choices.
Number 1.
Okay. Ooh, this is a very sad word. The word is dengue.
Kelsey,
should we change it?
No, this is good because we talked about malaria and you said dengue?
Yes, it's dengue. So,
how fortuitous for all of our infected viewers.
Honestly, the way people say it versus the way we're spelling it is not equal, but this
Oh, no. It's very important that we write exactly what Terry Burley is writing.
Oh, Terry. Thank you, Terry. Okay. So, this is the word dengue.
And in English, for those of you that are having trouble with it.
John, you focus on your job.
I already did my job.
Good.
So
you're
fast.
You're
getting extra from me.
I must
So, I'm going to step out of camera mics. The mic shut there.
All right. So, as our producer pointed out, or chose randomly, and as you saw, that was completely random. The word of the day.
I stake my reputation on the randomness of the word.
He states his reputation, as I do. So this is dengue, the word of the day, which is, wait, was it number 3 column, or number 2?
Just find the word on the page.
Oh, wait, number, yeah, there it is. Dengue, referencing dengue fever.
Mike's got the dengue fever!
Thankfully, I do not have dengue fever.
But if you go back to video 5, he does have some kind of fever.
Oh, I have the fever, that's for sure. Alright, anyways. Mosquito, now he stopped giving on all men dengue fever. So it is a disease spread by mosquitoes. And as far as I'm aware, it's really no good. Very, very no good.
I think one of our colleagues, Robert, has actually had dengue fever.
Are you serious? He got it?
I
didn't know that.
In Cambodia.
In Cambodia.
Oh, okay, that's different.
Oh, it's pretty much the same thing.
Yeah, but I don't know if any of us have gotten it yet, so we're doing pretty good.
We're doing alright.
Yeah.
E alright,
you straight, CCC.
E good, nice one.
E good, nice one. Okay, so that's dengue in Bishlama. The fever that you hope to never get.
And Mike, if you would be so kind for our French viewers, if you could please review the pronouns one more time, just very quickly.
Je, moi, tu, il, elle, on, nous, vous, and that's ills and els.
And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, we hope
we'll see you
have
next lesson.
A nice spell.
I learned that.